What's up, YouTube? So, sadly, my car's alternator is, it's done. It's dead. It happened out of nowhere. It's like one day after work, I drove home, no problem. Then me and my friends were gonna go hang out, and it didn't start. Yeah, it's a big bummer. So, hopefully today I'm gonna go to the junkyard and try to find a alternator off another BMW. But still, same plan goes. Basically today I'm just gonna go paint the car. I got a satin white, I think it's called satin blossom white, and I think that color is gonna turn out sick. But right now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go jump my car so that way I can pull it into the backyard.
Would you rise up, come and meet me in the sky? Would you trust me when you're jumping from the heights? Would you fall in the name of love? When there's madness, when there's poison in your head, when the sadness leaves you broken in your bed, I will hold you in the depths of your despair. But it's all
somehow my batteries just went from 100% to like almost 30%, and I literally didn't even do anything but wipe the car up. So basically all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let the batteries charge while I go and tape up the windows and crap like that, meaning that I don't want white paint on. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna go do. Alright, so my friend and I got the whole car masked off and ready to go. Hopefully this turns out pretty good. From the way it's masked off, I think it's gonna come out good, because anything that I still wanted black is gonna obviously stay black, and none of the glass will be nasty. This is the part that I talked about in one of my earlier videos that I basically cut off and just by looking at it tried to match it from the other side, and I think it came out pretty good for something that I did for really cheap. And here goes the video.
Hey, can you lock down the expression? Hey, inside of me,
anyone's wondering why we're coating it like that, like we're just not even putting thick coats on right now, it's because it's insanely windy. So like the paint is just kind of spraying all over the place. It's really annoying, but on the next coat, we're gonna let it dry for 15 minutes. And then on the next coat, we're gonna actually try to do panel by panel. Something pretty nice. Rust-Oleum is really good paint, but it thins, sprays really thin lines. So I don't know, I should have got fat caps or something. But oh well. Hopefully I got enough footage for you guys. We're currently on the second or third coat, but my battery is like really low, like it already cut off earlier, so I lost a pretty good amount of footage. But I deleted some crap in the camera, but there's like so much stuff in it that I'm gonna have to deal with it later. Anyways, when I'm finished, I'll show the car and just talk about some other random crap. So I missed the spot. Oh, dude, it's coming out so good. I'm like really surprised that the spray paint came out this nice. Rust-Oleum, man. Get yourself a can. So we're basically done the car. We're just doing some last minute touch-ups. I'm doing the trim while my friend Matt does the roof. And there's actually like really no streaks on the car at all, which is insanely surprising. Like, so surprised about that. But after the paint cures, maybe like next week or a few weeks from now, I'm going to polish the car, wax it, so that way anything, like any minor imperfections, will be gone. Don't worry about front bumper. The only reason I painted the side skirts somewhat and the back bumper was because they were kind of just there and available, I guess I can say. But don't worry, I am getting that body kit maybe in a week or two. Probably 2 weeks, since I have to use a little bit of money to get a new alternator. And the reason we're rushing on the paint job is because next week I want to do the, or tomorrow or Monday, I want my car for Monday so I can go to work. But if not, it's all right. I'll get picked up or ask someone to drive me, but you know, that's fine. But yes, subscribe and stay tuned so that way you can see the 1M body kit that I'm gonna put on it, or Duraflex. I'm debating between the two because I actually like both of them, so we'll see. Most likely the 1M. I really like the 1M, as you all know if you watched my earlier videos. But here's the car so far. Looking sweet. Wow. To be honest, guys, I did not think it would turn out this good at all. Again, don't worry about the front bumper. It will be a different one and white, but wow. And I actually just noticed, got to take some tape off, so I'm gonna take that off. But anyways, guys, I think I'm gonna finish the video here. On my next video, I'm gonna be installing the carbon fiber black and white emblems, probably repainting my rims for now since I don't have the new ones. Hopefully I'll find the new turning things, whatever they're called, because you know the orange ones are ugly. I'll be installing the turning lights. I think I'm gonna start doing this a little more regularly, so you guys can expect a video on Tuesdays and Fridays. Fridays or Saturdays. So Tuesdays, Fridays, or Saturdays. But for sure it'll be twice a week, hopefully, if I have something to do with the car. But yeah, here's the finished product. And I am still planning on making like an intro video of like everything I've done to the car and all that good stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you subscribe, you will get more. So like, comment, subscribe. Oh, actually, I'm a scrub. One more thing. All the black, I'm eventually gonna redo like all this black, some minor overspray, you know, clean up the windows and stuff. I am gonna redo all of this in matte black so that way the car looks solid.